Hello, my lovely Cancerian folks. Welcome into my channel. Thank you so much for being here. And I hope that you're doing well. All right, this is Sage Sunset. So I'm here to get messages for you. This is what's coming up in your energy. Just general messages for your week ahead, Cancerian. I feel like many of you are still at a point where you're focusing on your financial stability, coming in alignment with your sense of self-worth also. Because when you feel good, Cancerian, then you feel like you have more to offer. You feel like you can be of service. So align with your sense of self, your sense of self-worth, your pride, your grace. Know who you are. Trust in who you are. Trust in the value. Trust in what you have to offer to this earth. This earth is connected to you as the fourth house, the earth, right? That's your nature, love. So really focus more on being natural, being true to yourself, and this will bring into you financial stability and abundance, level you up financially. So I feel like many of you are coming into this place of having a stable income, consistent income that is good for you, make you feel good, look good, act good, just be vibrant and outgoing, laughing, joyous. Maybe I feel some of you have Leo energy too within your chart, where you have that fun, enthusiastic energy about you, where you bring life also to the party, right, Cancerian? Grounded and unstable. I feel earth energy here. That's Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Some of you have already established your business or are looking to really set up a business that's going to work for you. Some of you could be blocking or aligning with your value system. So this is another two, alignment. So this is you, could be aligning with another person in business. This is you aligning with something that makes you feel stable, grounded, trusting in yourself, trusting in your intuition, trusting in what it is that you bring. So being led by not what is seen in your physically manifested world, but really tapping into your energetic field. I feel like that's what you're doing here, to really see value, to see money flourishing into your life, using your intuition. Using your intuition to make decisions going forward, possibly in love. Going forward, Cancer, and some of you may want to just move forward, move out, move on, move away from, or move into something brand new. Releasing burdens, releasing what held you back in the past, ideas, feelings, relationships, and just going on this new journey ahead. But do you feel stable enough to do so? You know, Cancerians like their security. You may want to go off, but you're not able to do so because maybe you feel a bit barred in by another person. This could be a father figure here. This could be a love that's older than you. This could be someone that has their business set up or is just wise, a CEO, an entrepreneur. You know, this energy in your life, this person brings balance to you. I feel this person has land or governs over businesses. Person could be very like suspicious of you too, knowing that you want to go off and watching you. I wonder what they're going to do next. This person is just watching you if you're going to go off, I feel. The Wheel of Fortune. Heaven is on your side. You are backed by your connection to divinity here. Blessings. You see, you notice blessings, beautiful things happening around you. I feel like you're giving thanks for all of that. It's keeping you grounded. So the Wheel of Fortune makes you feel like wherever you go, there'll be good in it for you. Thoughts, ideas, feelings. Maybe some of you are deciding to set up your business as mentioned earlier, but you have to be going through the motions of it, eliminating what's not serving you and standing up for what you believe is serving you. And I feel you do have the upper hand, but you could be moving away from this energy of having to fight and fuss, just moving into a more stable place where you're on that path, things are working out for you. I feel suspicion, as if a person might want to really keep you trapped here, seeing that you want to move forward, or seeing how you're feeling, maybe feeling sorry for yourself, some of you, considering getting a taste of a life that you truly want to live, but you're not really moving toward it as yet. Considering, I feel this could also be bad news coming in for some of you. Just something coming up that's not going to be very pleasant in your future. And this is your next 7 days. And it could be coming by way of this Emperor figure that I said is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. It's as if they are your guards, your watch, your the police officer or guards watching you, as if they have the right to watch over you to ensure that you're not moving forward. And maybe if you try to move forward too quickly, too abrasively, to just step out of, like, as if to move away from discussions, to shut off or to shut down or to become silent, and this person may feel like they're losing control over you, and they don't like that, I feel. And so they'll try to come in and try to entrap you again, maybe with words. Maybe you feel like a victim, you feel maybe powerless toward this energy here. Cancerian, another way to look at this is that you are being the victor of your story. Look at how these cards are aligned here, right? As if you're moving away from this victim mentality, standing up for yourself, whether in words, having to defend yourself verbally, physically taking action to move forward. I feel like this person, though, they're ifing and butting in and out of wanting to be the dominant force in your life and maybe wanting to let you go. But I feel like you're moving past this phase of being stuck, whether that's in energy, in thought, in feeling, in emotions, or in physical location. Following your heart, I feel like you'll be following your heart forward. And I feel like that's how you conquer this person. For some of you who do have this energy, because Cancer, and sorry to say this, you can become praised, right? Predators want to seek out after you because you have such a loving and giving heart. And it is not something to look down on. It is for those of us, or you, that are not aware of your power, your true gifts, your true strengths. Right, so you may fall victim to some people or to some situations, seeing as if you're an easy target, right? And anyone that wants to control you feel like they have a lack of control in their own life, so they have to try to control someone else. You're going to move past the situation. Remember, you have a lot of blessings here on your trod. Wherever you go, things are going to fall into place for you. Oh my gosh, the world. Oh my God, I feel so good. I feel like you'll be traveling, because really, moving from this bound state and moving into the world energy, something brand new and beautiful could be coming into your world, something that's going to bring balance, healing, rejuvenation, a sense of self, just your pure self. This feels Cancerian too, with that mothering energy. We see the breasts are exposed. It's like that mothering, nurturing life force. This could be a baby coming into being here, right? This could be just you moving into your new life with the blessings that you have, your true self as a beautiful, giving person, right? Moving from being an easy target to really being angelic in sense, knowing your true grit, your power. I love this energy. This is what's coming up for you in the new, in the week ahead. Travel, an opportunity to travel or to bring good things into your world, right? Bringing good things, Wheel of Fortune, into your world. You have the upper hand here. You have what it takes, Cancerian, to move forward and away from what is not serving you. Look at this life you're leaving behind. Oh my. If you are one, if those of you who went through this, please let me know in the comment section. And I thank you for that, if you do. Moving into a brand new world of being stable, grounded, trusting in your intuitions, starting to become financially stable and independent, because you are wise, Cancerians are financially intelligent, knowing how to use money, how to save, how to budget, how to spend, how to make themselves feel good. Oh my God, I love it. This is how you feel. Do you hear my voice? Free. Amazing, awesome, born again, once again. Some of you could be having children, a new child born under the sun. This is also saying you're present, you're very present. You know there's nothing new under the sun. This is you in your glory, moving forward, looking toward that brand new day, things flourishing and prospering around you. Material success and happiness. Happiness inside of yourself, loving yourself purely, releasing all the ideas that you have accumulated about yourself from your past, your childhood. Maybe because Cancerians as children, in my experience as a Cancerian, I was very emotional. And then I'd be kind of put down because of my emotions and because of my intuitive abilities too, to see what's coming. My intuitive nature to know what's going on, even in my family settings. And so I'd be shut down. And so sometimes I'd crawl away into a little box and decide not to speak. But look at this, bursting out into the light, free from captivity. Mental captivity also, that has to do with your emotions, how you express yourself. Trusting in the way you choose to express yourself, being grounded and stable, believing that when you speak, it comes from your heart, and learning even how to speak and act and express yourself from your heart space, your soul, the sun, your soul energy, your vibrancy, your beauty. Oh my God, your strength, your power, your grace, the ability for you, ability that you have to reign, to lead, to guide, to nurture, to uphold, to bring forth life. To use your energies as even your magician energies. For me, this is the magician card in another expression, right? Look how she's taming that lion. That's magic. That's just aligning with the forces of nature. Remember, your strengths are your true gifts, Cancerian. And when people shut you down, you tend to hide and go back in your shell and not really live out and express yourself in your true strength. That's what I'm saying. Be strong and confident. This is confidence too. Grace, knowing how to really use that soft, intuitive nature that you have to turn bad situations to light, to change energies around, to tame the lion. And this could be even in you, okay? To influence, to be an influence of your surroundings, of your environment. So act naturally. Act naturally as you are, and you're definitely influencing your home, your loved ones, and just everything in your environment here. Oh my God, I love this energy. It's so promising, beautiful. In your home, you are strong. Be brave. Stand up for what you believe in. Don't let anyone feel like they can keep you captive. You are strong. No one wants to tame a weak person. This person is not taming a rabbit, right? She's taming a lion. If you weren't strong, this person would, or this situation wouldn't want to hold on to you. You get what I'm saying? So you have to come to know your strength, and that will set you free. That will set you free, my beautiful, beautiful Cancerian. Beautiful. You're very powerful. The infinity sign above your head here. Ins and outs all around. Connecting to nature. Go outside and walk barefoot. Remember to stay hydrated. Because water, we see the water, even though you're bound, you should remember to replenish yourself, replenish your soul, take care of you, rejuvenate, and give love to everyone, because love is universal, right? So offer love to even those that you feel are trying to hurt you or tame you or captivate you. I feel some of you could be afraid of expressing yourself or moving forward. Maybe afraid of conflict. Maybe afraid of standing up for yourself here. Some of you could be coming into a place of teaching, of using your intuition, your passion, your desire. I feel Leo energy once more here. At the beginning of the reading, I said I feel like I'm reading for Cancerians that have Leo or that fiery energy inside of them here. be careful of quarrels, right? So I feel like sometimes you feel like you're not in control of how you express yourself. But take a bird's eye view at this card and imagine you're the one looking at the quarrel, and then see how you can be more influential without even have to getting into the fuss. Because everyone here wants their voice to be heard, wants their opinion to be accepted. Everyone wants their business to flourish, their ideas to take off, right? So you're going to maybe set yourself away from the fuss and stand out. Let's see what's coming up for you. Another five. So there's a lot, there's some things that you're overcoming. And I feel like this is brand new. This is new ideas, new feelings. Moving past old ways of being in arguments, of wanting to defend yourself, of feeling like you can't even speak. Yes, as if you can't even get your voice out there. You can't speak, as if there's no place for your expression because there's just too much turmoil. Moving past this emotional entrapment, because sometimes we can get caught up in feeling just too attached to the ideas of the things that we think we've lost. But there's so much to look forward to behind here. With these two cups that's left behind, turn around, pick them up, and start a brand new day. I feel like this is what it's saying for me here. From nothing to something. Amazing. Coming into your confidence, your glory, being of service, staying true to yourself. Coming into your true, material success and abundance coming here for you. This could be a business partner coming in for you too. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. An offering of financial stability. Someone paying you for something that you're offering. Maybe you're a consultant. You help to resolve conflicts, you know. And then we have the Moon card at the bottom of the deck, which is something being lifted, being revealed beneath the surface, the water, the undercurrents, the undertones. So what is not really on the surface, but the undertones of life. Pay attention to people around you, because maybe there's someone around you they're keeping secrets from you, right? That's a way to look at it. Things are coming to light though. Because the energies of the planet don't allow things to stay hidden for too long. The truth always has to come to light. And this could be a truth in you, in who you are, how to move forward, what was keeping you trapped. Remember, tap into your water energy here. The moon energy, because that's who you are, your intuition, your natural essence. Really, going with the flow. I think this message is a revelation coming to you that this bond or entrapment is going to come you're going to realize it's sort of a delusion. It's a veil. It's not true. And you do have the ability, the strength to move forward. Okay? I think that's what the Moon card is saying here. You're going to realize that it's just a delusion. Oh my God, a delusion. And that's the next card here. The Devil card, delusions. So I feel like you just were caught up in these ideas that you're trapped and you're a victim and you can't move forward. And this could be coming from your environment, the people that you're surrounding yourself with. And so it takes you going into this place, blocking what's not serving you, Cancerian. Tapping into your moon energy, your water, right? Connecting to your divinity overpowers and overthrows any facade that could come present themselves to you. Remember, I want to leave you with these cards here. The Sun, the Strength, the Wheel of Fortune, and these are all major arcanas. So you do have heavenly blessings and guidance here from other realms coming into your presence here. The Emperor card, the Fool. And then we have the Devil here, which is another major arcana. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 major arcanas coming out in a reading. And they're beautiful. Okay? Much to look forward to in your 7 days ahead. We have just feel like liberation. Thank you. All right, Cancerian, that has been your reading for this week. I hope that you found messages that resonate with you and are able to help you along your journey, Cancerian. If you did like this reading, give my video a thumbs up. and subscribe to my channel for future uploads. Remember, Cancerian, on your way out, take this with you. You can be, do, have everything and anything in this world that you desire, because you are all, and all is within you. Much love, peace.